Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm going to show you a video that demonstrates the use of PDO, dissolvable polydioxinone threads, to create a beautiful, strong, defined jawline. You can use it with other procedures that define the jawline, such as radio frequency and injectable fat dissolving compounds such as Kybella. Let's go right to the video and I'll show you how to use the threads to create this. So here what we're doing are some threads. I've already put two in. Here's the jawline here. I want to define the jawline. There's a line that's coming down along the oral commissure. Some of our patients will get a crease here at the bottom of the jaw. I'm not trying to volumize, but there's a faint line here. When the patient moves, there is a line that forms, and that's an aging feature, even though the jawline is beautiful and strong. So I don't want to volumize, but with the threads, I'm using coiled 1.5 inch threads. I do not want to add a thread right along that jawline. Get the patient to bite down. So here's the front of the masseter, relax, and I know my facial arteries right here. You might not be able to see this, but right along here I can see a more superficial vessel I'm trying to avoid. And now I'm going to come underneath the jaw. This is the faint line you may not be able to see on camera, but here I'm using this coiled thread, poke. You need to be at the right depth and then maintain your depth. It's much similar, very similar to doing cannula injections, okay? And this coils in. The coil thread does give a tiny bit of volume, which I'm okay with because I'm adding volume just above the bony prominence and underneath it. But it's not going to give too much volume where I'm losing the definition. I suppose that's just a little bit of experience to know how much volume the threads are going to give you. Now this one, instead of coming down here, which might be a little bit more awkward for me, I'm going to come in more anterior. Again, I'm leaving the prominence. I'm seeing the line here in the fold that I want to stop, poke here. And there's many ways to do threads along the jawline, but it really depends. Every patient's going to be different. Here I'm trying again to prevent loose skin, okay? And so I'm not trying to volumize. There's no real area of submental fat that I'm trying to tighten up. I'm strictly trying, and here's that vessel right here. I'm going to go underneath it this time, so just a tad deeper. Once I go underneath that vessel, then I pop up by moving my flexible needle downwards. That will get my tip up, get my level of plane, and by that way I am avoiding that vessel. It's really nice because these rarely bruise people. So there you go. That's my pattern for this particular patient. Now, I could make a case for going through this line here, but we can also use collagen-stimulating injectable products up through this region as well. Just as you get to the thinner neck tissue, it's not as safe to do that, and the threads are much better and actually can work together along with your injectables. And now, I simply pull the needles out and the threads remain in the skin, okay? So you can see just a tiny bit of bleeding there, tiny, and that's going to help define the jawline. We have our threads in place and a beautiful jawline. We'll also place a couple barb threads through here to create a posterior vector and to tighten the skin. And again, I don't want to volumize this area, but we can see we want to define the jawline. You know, what we do a lot, including reducing submental fat with injections, with cold procedures such as cool sculpting and Kybella. And the jawline plays such an important part in beauty and health and vibrance. So there you see it. Those are threads to create a beautiful jawline and tighten the skin. So there you see PDO threads used to create a beautiful defined jawline. If you like this video, click like. Better yet, also subscribe for further tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.